According to the internet, all pre-builts suck.
This video is sponsored by Silverstone, the leader in small form factor power supplies for over 10 years. The Extreme 850R Platinum is the world's first commercially available SFX 12V 4.0 power supply. This specification is the SFX equivalent to the latest ATX 3.0 spec and includes the PCIe Gen 5 12V high power connector and all of the great performance upgrades over previous gen power supplies. Pick up the Extreme 850R Platinum today and give your small form factor PC the power supply it deserves.
Hey Internet, Gordon with PC World. I'm here with Braythorn.
Hello, how's it going?
And you can catch his content over on
YouTube.com/Braythorn.
Oh, he's got that. I not figured that out. Go over there, please like and subscribe. Of course, smash that bell. But I want to talk about to Braythorn about a topic that is very near and dear to my heart. Also very near and dear to your heart, because I know the internet thinks pre-built PCs suck. You actually cover a lot of pre-built content on your channel.
Yes.
Do they suck? Do they suck, Bray?
Okay. Like anything out there, yes, some do. Also, some are awesome. It's like any product. It's weird that way. So there are a lot of system integrators out there. It's a massive industry. And it serves a lot of people, mostly people who are new to PCs. So I felt that there was sort of a lack of content for people who are specifically looking for pre-built, which even as someone who's been doing DIY for 25 years, I've always felt like pre-builts are okay. And then it became more of a, hey, these are awesome because they're a gateway
right
for people who want to get into PC building, but even with all the resources, they still feel too intimidated. It's a great way to get a system that is warrantied, has all, everything's compatible. That's one of the big things, right, when you're speccing a system.
Right.
Got to make sure everything's got great compatibility, that it works well. So that's like a cheat code to get into it, and then you have something that, that runs. I mean, did you build your first car?
Right. No, I haven't built any of my cars, but yes, right. You're not going to.
It's not the best.
Yeah, but no, it is fair because I think I really want to talk to you about this because I've been a DIYer for a long, long time. I can't remember the last time I had a pre-built machine. At the same time, I think it serves a very valuable service to get people into a PC. We were talking about this earlier. I would rather have somebody buy a pre-built system from an OEM or system integrator than to go buy a product that isn't a PC.
Exactly.
Because we get a strength in numbers. The more PC gamers there are, the more people that are using PCs, that means you have a larger audience and
we don't need to get into that stuff. That's analytics stuff and then audience stuff. Yeah.
Yeah. No, also, I think a lot of people also underestimate the size of pre-builts. And
right.
They think very much the entire world is all about DIY. That's 90% of the universe. It's actually kind of reverse of that almost,
yes.
Right?
So when it comes to the PC hardware market, it's about 90% to 10%. 90% of people who buy PC hardware, more or less, will get something from an OEM or a system integrator, yet about 90% of content is catering to DIY. So all those people really don't have a lot of resources when it comes to like, what should I look for? What should I get? What is Intel? What's an AMD? And I just try to give them a jumping in point. And then I'm going to be doing some DIY content to sort of help people transition into doing some really. How easy is it to add storage?
Right.
You know, swapping out RAM. The really easy stuff that sort of gets your feet wet and you're sort of like, okay, that was fine. I opened it. It didn't explode. Everything's
right.
Good.
Yeah.
So and I've been there when I first started. I remember that feeling. The family computer where I'm like, I need more space so I can not have to uninstall MechWarrior 3 just so I can play StarCraft.
Right, right.
Right? I need more space. So I know that trepidation of like, do I really want to crack this open?
Right, and yeah, you know, yeah. Honestly, if your parents buy you a $1,200, $1,000, $900 system, even entry level $700 PC
yeah.
for gaming, it's pretty scary to open the thing up and start screwing around with it as a teenager, as somebody's younger. Because you break
yeah.
it, your parents are gonna be like, they're not gonna be too happy you broke that machine, right? So.
No, they weren't. When it happened. I know that feeling too.
But did you tell them? Did you just like, how's it? Look, I haven't seen you playing with a computer.
Don't use a computer for about a week. Don't use it for about a week. By the way, when do I get my allowance?
Yeah.
No, it's really, we forget that feeling after, you know, a couple decades of doing this. You know, that's where I'm at. And it's easy to forget that, but then it's also, you forget the sort of wonderment when you're first getting into it. Like, this can really do anything. And pre-builts are just a really solid way to get into it. Yes, there are some pitfalls out there. There are some things that I don't recommend in my videos, some things that I really do recommend in my videos. But the main thing is that you want to get a real big picture about it. Don't listen to any one review you read. Don't just watch one video on a certain brand, because there are, if someone got a bad sample, they got a bad device, that's one out of thousands. iBuyPower in 2021 sold 600,000 PCs. That's more than Dell.
Wow.
And those are all PCs that have off-the-shelf components that can be swapped out, upgraded, things like that. It's a beautiful thing. That's a lot of new enthusiasts.
Right. That's 600,000 people that are into desktop PCs. And honestly, the world has mostly moved on to laptops. That's something people don't realize. A lot of people, the vast majority of the world buys laptops. So the more people we get into desktops, that is a good thing for us. Because you need that audience to still make it possible. Like, you know what? If you had such a small audience that it's not worth it to make these parts, they're not gonna make them.
So exactly.
If they're making them for everybody who buys OEM machines, SI machines, DIY, that means more, higher volume, better prices, better for everybody.
Right. And you know, it's funny because it was really during the shortages that I started doing this. Because you couldn't buy parts.
Right.
You know, whether we wanted to or not. Now, of course, we can just do that and keep the industry going, but you just couldn't get a GPU. So what did I do? I bought a pre-built. DIY, a hardcore DIY guy who was fine with it for other people. Yeah, I get a pre-built, that's fine. You know, I'll help you with it if you need it. But for myself, I was like, I'm gonna bite the bullet and get this. And you know what I did? I unbuilt it and rebuilt it into a different case. And I built a PC. So that's when I was like, I gotta tell other people about this. And then System Integrators Weekly started. It's not the best name.
Yeah.
It's kind of on the nose, but I haven't thought of another one. It's been about 80 episodes. I don't know.
So can I ask you, what are like the top three questions that you get? Like, so you're catering to a new audience.
Right.
They were buying pre-built. What are their top three questions that they always, like common themes, like what do they want to know? Like, what are they buying? Do they want to upgrade? Do they want to know about tuning?
Right.
Or do they just want to know how to do OS stuff?
Well, a lot of it has to do with encountering surface level information, right? That just causes more questions. So the main question I get though is a short question with a very long answer, right? Is this good? Is this good? Or what is best?
Yeah.
Two words that don't work for something like this because they're subjective.
Yeah.
Right? So now what I actually really got into was in my Twitch streams as well, I help people one-on-one through a queue system because everybody's needs are different. Even if there'll be big groups of people who have similar needs, their individual needs, very slight differences will be there. So if you're going to be doing just gaming, that's an easy one, right?
Right.
But what if I game, but also I'm a photographer on the side. I like to edit photos. Okay, well, that changes the spec. I need to edit video. Whoa, okay, that could be a dedicated workstation. We're combining that into one PC, and it really gets nuanced at that point. So best and good, whenever I get that question, I have to answer it with questions. What are you gonna do with it? What's your budget? What are you looking for? Do you want a white case or a black case? Things like that.
Right, right.
So that's the main question I get. Is this good? Is this good? Someone will send me a link to a PC and say, is this good for me? I'm like, I don't know what you need. I don't know you. So I started doing it one-on-one, and that worked out really. It's a lot of fun. You would think just talking about PCs and helping people find PCs on a Twitch stream would be boring, right? It's like, okay, next. It's actually really hype. It turned into a whole thing. So it's a lot of fun, where we like celebrate when someone's like, I found it, I bought this PC. Is this a big decision?
Yeah, you know, I will say that is one of the biggest lies that we push all the time is best. What's the best thing?
Right.
And it's never what's the best thing. The question is, what's the best thing for me? And people have to realize it's all personalized, catered to your own needs.
Right.
And a lot of it's always pushed to what's the best. And that's not always works. So it's funny that you're running into that in that audience too, so.
Right, I mean, you guys do so many reviews of things.
Right.
And that you're presenting objective information to subjective people.
Right.
And that's to subjective viewpoints. So that, I haven't gotten to that point to where I'm doing that many of those. I'm catering to, I'll be sent pre-built PCs, I'll review them. With a grain of salt, they knew they were sending it to me.
Sure.
You know?
Common.
But you get to see their best intentions at that point, at least. This is what they do at their best.
Okay. Okay, last question before I let you go, because he's got a lot of stuff to do at CES. You don't want to miss that in CES. What are kind of like, what's the worst kind of script? Don't name vendors, no shaming here, but what's kind of the worst thing you've dinged somebody for? How about top three of the worst things you've dinged people for?
Okay.
In reviews.
Well, I don't know how this happened, but I get obsessive about detail when I'm inspecting a PC. That's kind of why I do, one of the reasons I do what I do. I saw a little piece, I was looking at the RAM, and there's a little shine on the end of it, a stick of RAM, so I popped it out. And it was a long, hard piece of flat plastic under the heat spreader.
Huh.
Under the heat spreader. I don't know, it's like the packaging for RAM, you know how it's hard plastic?
Right.
It was wedged under the heat spreader.
Oh, interesting.
That's, I get it if you don't see that, it's tiny, but it wasn't tiny. It was the tip of the iceberg. I yanked the iceberg out of the RAM, so that one bugged me. That was something. The RAM was fine.
Okay.
No RAM was harmed in the filming of this stream that I was streaming actually.
Okay.
And then there was a motherboard that just had XMP disabled. No problem. It's okay. That's, you ding them for that.
Okay.
And then you realize why it's good for them to enable XMP.
Enable or disable?
To enable.
Okay.
Because the motherboard couldn't enable it. It was failing. Oh. So that would have been a QC win if they had caught that.
Right.
You want your parts to fail at the, you know, where you're building it. You don't want it to fail in the customer's desk or under the desk. Don't put your PCs on the floor. Don't do that. That's a Paul thing. Anyway, it's true. Don't do that.
Wait, he says don't put it on your desk?
Don't put it on your floor. So don't put it on your floor. Don't put it on carpet. Don't put it on your intake for your power supply.
You've never heard
on
that
carpet?
I just
that?
Don't.
Wait. So your PC's on the floor?
It's on the floor. It's
on carpet?
My PC's too damn big to put on the desk. It's too big. We're going home.
All right,
we're going to go. We're going. I'm disgusting everybody. You know what, Mike? I've already been hated on for one, my PC is on the floor. Two, I have a 1080p TV in my living room because I'm not paying for a 4K TV set. So that's another no. And I like matte. I like matte monitors. I don't like the glossy stuff, okay? But enough about things to beat up on Gordon about. This has been great. Again, where do we go to see your videos?
I'm sorry. Don't leave me hanging. I'm sorry.
Oh,
it has been great, though. My videos. You can go to youtube.com/Brayathorn. It's weird. I know. It's like, I might rebrand it at some point. But that's what it is right now. And that's, there you go. And also, my Twitch streams are at twitch.tv/Brayathorn. And that's Braethorn.
Cool. And of course, stay here on this channel. Don't tune away. Click on one of them bells down there, like, subscribe. And please tune into PC World's channel for more awesome PC coverage from CES 2023.